Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the TEAS. We have been solving math problems out of this book here, the TEAS study manual, the 6th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. Today, we'll solve some problems that you will find on page number 68, problems dealing with order of operations, something that we talked about yesterday, something that we talked about day before yesterday. And before I forget it, if at the end of having done these problems, you decide that you wish to have some more practice, you will find that we have solved every single math problem that appeared in the 5th edition. You will find the solutions to problems in 5th editions, TEAS 5th edition, from day number 1 through 80. And the problems that we're dealing with today, the problems dealing with the concept of order of operations, was the very first concept that was covered in 5th edition, and you will find those problems on the very first day. Just type in TEAS, day 1, and watch the video where you will find some more problems dealing with the order of operations. In addition to that, if you want even more practice than that, there is another series that you can watch, which is the basic math series, if you want to improve your math skill. Just type in basic math, day 46 and 47, which is where we did problems dealing with PEMDAS. Okay, let's get going. No? We finished the examples on page number 68. We finished all the examples. What we're going to do in this video are the practice problem that you see in the margin on page 68. So let's do that. These are practice problems. Practice problems on page 68. Number one, part A. 4 plus 3 times 9 minus 6 in the parentheses. And we know from our order of operation that the parentheses is the very first thing we do. We have our mnemonic. Mnemonic is just a memory device, and the memory device that people use is this acronym, PEMDAS, which a lot of people end up using the words, please excuse my dear Aunt Sally. Please excuse my dear Aunt Sally is a very nice mnemonic device. It helps us remember in which order should we perform our operations. The very first one is the P, which stands for parentheses. We see one here. Let's do that first. 4 plus 3 times 9 minus 6 is 3. Now we see simply addition. Oh no, there is a multiplication here. We have to do this first. I thought this was a subtraction. Since multiplication is there, we should do multiplication first before we worry about addition. So it becomes 4 plus 3 times 3 is 9. And finally, the answer is 13. Answer to this problem is 13. Let's do part B. Part B says 12 minus 2 divided by 11 minus 6. Let's see what we can do. Again, we do our parentheses first before we worry about anything else. 12 minus 2 is 10. Bring the division sign. 11 minus 6 is 5. 10 divided by 5 is 2. A very simple, very straightforward problem. Let's look at part C. Part C says 30 minus 3 times 2 over 18 minus 24 divided by 2. How do we do this problem? How do we go about it? Any idea? Well, when you have a fraction, we have to do the numerator and the denominator separately. Let's do the numerator here. The numerator and the denominator separately. The numerator is right here. 30 minus 3 times 2. We're going to do this separately. And 18 minus 24 divided by 2.
let's do them separately. Here we see the multiplication sign, so we can do multiplication first. So this is 30 minus 6, and 30 minus 6 is 24. We're done with the numerator. Now we do 18, bring down the 18, minus, we see 24 divided by 2, 24 divided by 2. Division has to be done first before we worry about subtraction. Division is first before we worry about addition or subtraction. 24 divided by 2 is 12. And now 18 minus 12 is 6. That's it, we're done with this thing. We can put down the answer. The top part was 24. The bottom part was 6. 24 divided by 6 is 4. The answer is 4. Other way we could have looked at this problem is, watch what happens. It's the exact same problem, but presented to us a little bit differently. It's the exact same problem. When we have a fraction, when something is presented as a fraction, we do the top separately and we do the bottom separately. You see how I did it? Top separately and then the bottom separately. Do the top separately and then the bottom separately. And then do the division. This is the exact same problem as what we just did there. And instead of writing in the fractional form, had they written this in horizontally, the problem would have been written in this manner. They would have written the problem in this manner. That's it. In which case, we would have done the parentheses first, and inside the parentheses, we would have done 3 times 2 first, which gives us 6. We would have done this part first, 24 divided by 2 gives us 12. We still would have had our parentheses, we still would have had our division, and then division would come down, 30 minus 6 is 24, divided by 30, 24 divided by 6 gives us 4. Same answer as before. But these two problems are one and the same, they are not different. Problem number two, we'll encounter something that we discussed both yesterday and day before yesterday. Make sure you watch all the video in the proper sequence. Don't go all over the place willy-nilly. Have some system, have some methodology, have some method, have some plan. Don't go all over the place like a bunch of chickens running around the farm with their heads cut off. That's not what I call organized. This is what's given to us. Number two. Well, we have to do multiplication first. Right there, multiplication first. We'll do that first. So 3 comes down, 2 times 6 is 12, and then minus 4. And now yesterday we talked about the fact that addition and subtraction, they have the same preference, they have the same status. Just like multiplication and division, they have the same status. So when we have an expression that involves nothing but addition and subtraction, and since they both have the same status, who goes first? Who should yield to whom? That's the question. Who should yield to whom? In which case, the convention is, we must go strictly from left to right. Strictly from left to right. Don't do 12 minus 4 first. So 3 plus 12 is 15. And 15 minus 4 is 11. Now, if you did this first, 12 minus 4 is 8, and 8 plus 3 is 11, it does give you the same answer in this case, but that will not always be the case. So you will get burned in some cases, depending on the situation. Here, it doesn't matter, but some cases it does matter if you end up doing something silly. Always play safe and go from left to right. Do you understand? As you will see, in a problem that I'll give you in a little bit in a few seconds time. Let's do number three. In number three, we have something written in the fraction form. 15 plus 2 times 5 over 11. Minus 24 divided by 4.
We're going to do the same thing what we did before. We're going to do a numerator and denominator separately.
Let's do our numerator and denominator separately. Here's our numerator, here's our denominator. 15 plus 2 times 5, and the denominator is 11 minus 24 divided by 4. Keep them separate.
Figure out what numerator is separately, figure out what the denominator is separately, and then divide the numerator by the denominator.
In the numerator, we see 2 times 5. We have to do multiplication first. 2 times 5 is 10. So we have 15 plus 10. We end up with 25 in the numerator. In the denominator, at the bottom part, again we see a division. Division is to be done first. So we can end up with 11 minus 24 divided by 4 is 6. 11 minus 6 is 5. There you go. So the final answer is going to be 25 divided by 5. You have 25 on the top. We have 5 at the bottom. 25 divided by 5 is 5.
Now the same question, instead of writing in the fractional form, instead of presenting the problem in fractional form, had they written the problem in the horizontal form, the question would have looked like this. The same question would have looked like this. The exact same question. Nothing is going to change. It's going to be the exact same question, but presented a little bit differently.
We can present the same problem in horizontal form. It would have looked like this. We have to do this part first because this is the numerator. We have to do this part separately. This is the denominator. And then we are supposed to divide the two.
In which case,
we would have done this part first. 2 times 5 is 10, but we would have had a parenthesis around it. 11, we have a parenthesis around it. This parenthesis comes down. And we have a division sign there. Everything else is the same.
You see the similarity between the two? They are the exact same problem. That was number 3. Let's do a few more. We're going to do 3 more bonus problems, 4, 5, and 6, which are not in the book. Okay, very quickly. 3, 4, 5, and 6. They're not in the book. See if you can handle them.
Number 4 is 5 minus 2 squared plus 6.
Let's see what we can do. First thing first, parentheses come first, so we can figure out what 5 minus 2 is.
5 minus 2 is 3, so we have 3 squared plus 6.
What comes next? After parentheses comes exponent. We see an exponent here.
We have an exponent of 2. We have to take care of that part first. 3 squared is 9. And then plus 6, which is equal to 15.
Let's do one more.
Number 5.
Oh, number 5 is a very long one. I'm going to erase this thing. We'll put number 5 all at once. It's very long. If we start from the bottom, we won't have the room at the bottom to finish it.
18 divided by 6 in the parentheses times 4 minus 8 plus 3 times 5 minus 9.
3 times 5 minus 9. That's a 5.
What do we do first?
Well,
we see parentheses first. That has to be done first.
Let's do that first.
18 divided by 6 is 3. So 3 times 4. Bring everything else down. Don't try to do too many things together.
That part is done. Now what do we do? Now we do our multiplication. I see one multiplication there, one multiplication there. Multiplication comes first.
Before you worry about addition or subtraction, we're going to do this and this. 3 times 4 is 12, minus 8. 3 times 5 is 15, minus 9.
Now we're just left with addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction are the same status. Which one do we do first?
Well, the rule is very simple. Go strictly from left to right.
12 minus 8 is 4,
plus 15, minus 9.
4 plus 15 is 19,
minus 9 gives us 10.
The answer to this problem is 10. One last one, and then we'll call it a day.
Plus, open parenthesis, 4 times 4 plus 7, close parenthesis,
Now when we have more than one parenthesis, the rule is that we must do the innermost first. The innermost is this one. We have to do this one first before we worry about the outside one. So 4 plus 7 is 11. So this guy comes down. 4 times 4 plus 7 is 11. And then close the parenthesis. And here, line up everything. Bring everything down. So 4 plus 7 was 11. We got it here. This 4 came down. So now we have to do 4 times 11. 4 times 11 is 44. And then 3 plus 44 is 47 is the final answer. The final answer to the problem is 47. As I said, if you need more practice, you can watch these day 1 or you can watch basic math day 46 and 47. You will find many more problems dealing with the concept of order of operations. Okay, bye now.